हॅलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ लेक्चरर अदिती अनिल कुशारे, मास्टर ऑफ फार्मसी इन क्वालिटी अश्युरन्स टेक्निक्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्सपेरिमेंट्स फ्रॉम फार्मास्युटिक्स टू. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेमी सॉलिड डोसेज फॉर्म्स. इन दॅट द सेमी सॉलिड डोसेज फॉर्म्स आर मेनली मीन फॉर एक्सटर्नल ॲप्लिकेशन. फॉर एन एक्झाम्पल, ऑइंटमेंट, क्रीम्स, जेलीज, पेस्ट्स, पोल्टिसेस, ETC. इन दॅट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑइंटमेंट्स. सो ऑइंटमेंट्स, these are the semi solid preparations meant for external application to the skin or mucous membrane. They usually contain a medicament or medicaments dissolved, suspended or emulsified in an ointment base. Ointment bases, it is that substance or the part of an ointment which serves as a carrier or vehicle for the medicament. While selecting a suitable ointment base, the factors such as the action desired, nature of the medicament to be incorporated and the stability of ointment are to be considered. So we will discuss about the classification of ointment in detail. There are total two classes: therapeutic properties based on penetration and second class which is based on therapeutic uses. So therapeutic properties based on penetration get classified into three types, that is epidermic ointments, endodermic ointments, diadermic ointments. According to the layer of skin, all these three types of ointments are get classified. Therapeutic uses, in that first antibiotic ointments, antifungal ointments, anti-inflammatory ointments, antipruritic ointments, astringent ointments, anti-eczematous ointments, keratolytic ointment, counter irritant ointments, for dandruff treatments, for psoriasis, then parasiticide ointments and protectant ointments. Next we will discuss about the classification of ointment bases. There are total four main classes, in that oleaginous base, then absorption base, emulsion base and water soluble base. In oleaginous base, first type is a petrolatum, that is a soft paraffin which is having melting point of 38 degree Celsius to 56 degree Celsius. Second one, hard paraffin, and third, liquid paraffin. Absorption bases again get classified into two types, that is non-emulsified bases, and second one, water in oil emulsion, that is WYO emulsion, in which water is the internal phase while oil acts as the external phase. In non-emulsified bases, it is again of the four types, that is, for an example, wool fat, wool alcohol, hydrous wool fat, beeswax. Then emulsion bases is of two types. O by W means oil in water emulsion, in which oil acts as an internal phase while water acts as an external phase. And second one, that is W by O emulsion, in which water acts as an internal phase while oil acts as an external phase. Water soluble bases, carbovaxes. Then factors which govern the selection of an ideal base for ointments are, there are total two factors, that are dermatological factors and pharmaceutical factors. In dermatological factor, there are again they are of seven types, that is absorption and penetration first factor, second one, that is effect on skin function, then miscibility with skin secretions and serum, then compatibility with the skin secretions, freedom from irritant effect, emollient properties, ease of application and removal. Second, that is pharmaceutical factor, in that it is having the four points, that are stability, solvent properties, emulsifying properties and consistency. Then preparation of ointment, in that there are four methods, that is trituration method, fusion method, chemical reaction method and fourth one, emulsification method. Let's discuss about the additives used in ointment, that are preservatives, methyl paraben or propyl paraben, humectants, that are glycerin, propylene glycol or sorbitol, antioxidants which are used to prevent the oxidative decomposition, chelating agent is used to prevent the catalyzing oxidative degradation of the trace elements. So we know the example of antioxidants, that are BHA, butylated hydroxyanisole, or butylated hydroxytoluene, BHT. Then in case of chelating agent, that is the best example is EDTA, means ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, which is the best example of chelating agent, that is also known as the sequestering agent. Recommended containers, the semi-solid preparations are dispensed in the glass or the plastic jars having screw caps with the impermeable liner. They should be stored in the well-closed container so as to prevent the loss of volatile constituents. They can also be supplied in the plastic or the metallic collapsible tubes. Then special labeling instructions in that store in a cool place for ointment containing low melting point ingredients, and second one, that is for external use only. In next session we will see in detail about the experiments. Experiment number 57. Title of this experiment is to prepare and submit the methyl salicylate ointment BP, that is British Pharmacopoeia 10 gram. Proposition 1. Methyl salicylate is a volatile liquid and should be added to the base at as low temperature as possible. Proposition 2 is beeswax helps to stiffen the base. Learning objectives are to understand the purpose of ointment and its method of preparation, and to prepare and label the ointment correctly. Apparatus required are beaker, measuring cylinder, ointment spatula, ointment tile, evaporating dish, etc. Factor calculated as quantity required upon quantity given is equal to 10 upon 1000, that is equal to 0.01. So prescription is given over here, which is denoted by the symbol RX. Methyl salicylate 500 gram, white beeswax 250 gram, hydrosulfate 250 gram. So let's discuss in detail about the formula table. We have this type, that is the category user, role of ingredient, translation means the name of ingredient, quantity given in imperial system is not written over here, as we have the quantities are not given in the Latin terminology, that is directly given in the metric. So we have the quantity given in the metric system to prepare up to 1000 gram, and quantity taken in the metric system to prepare up to 10 gram. So first of all, we have methyl salicylate, which is used as a counter irritant. Quantity given is a 500 gram and taken quantity should be 5 gram, which is calculated with the help of factor. Second, white beeswax, which is used to stiffen the base. Quantity given should be 250 gram and taken quantity is 2.5 gram. Hydrosulfate used as an ointment base and emollient. Quantity given is a 250 gram and taken quantity should be 2.5 gram. Direction to be used as directed by physician. Now we have this methyl salicylate, which is a previously made. This is a hydrosulfate. This is a hydrosulfate. And third one, we have the white beeswax. So this white beeswax and this hydrosulfate, I am going to melt it into this evaporating dish, and after melting then we will proceed for next part. So now I am going to melt this onto this water bath. After melting we will proceed for next addition of methyl salicylate into it. Now after cooling this solution, I am going to add methyl salicylate into it. Then we will proceed for next, stir it properly, and after proper cooling we will transfer it into this container, and then we will proceed for next labeling part. So now we will move towards labeling part. So ointment 10 gram for ABC means name of patient, register number, that is XYZ, which is number given in the register, dispensed by PQM, means name of pharmacist, date September 2020, this is the manufacturing date. Store in cool and dark place, this is the storage condition. For external use only, to be used as directed by physician, manufactured by 11 farms in Nasik. Result, the 10 gram of ointment is submitted in this wide mouth bottle